Bueno, es que realmente para este tipo de streamings me gustaría poner una cam más genérica. Sí. Porque claro, no voy a estar pendiente del PC ahora. Tendría que crearme otra escena. Tendría que estar... Es que claro, ahora voy a estar pendiente de esto. Podría poner el vídeo este. Mola. Es que voy a estar leyendo. Vamos a esperar a que se haga el tiempo, porque 4 minutos son 4 minutos. Y le metemos caña una horita más. Y ya mañana, pues, seguiremos. Aunque a lo mejor hago un poco más. A lo mejor me quedo hasta las 12. Depende de cómo me saco otra. Porque me gustaría terminarlo. Lo que ahora tengo un problema para hacer los vídeos. O sea, para hacer los GIFs. Los GIFs. Porque normalmente lo hago con el modo grabación de... Bueno, creo que lo puedo hacer igual, ¿no? ¿Puedo iniciar grabación mientras tengo una emisión? ¿O se peta esto? A lo mejor se peta, ¿no? Podría ser que se petase. No lo voy a probar ahora, lo probaré luego, si hace falta. Lo probaré luego. No, la verdad es que no sé qué hacer. ¿Qué podemos ver por aquí? Quedan 2 minutitos y medio. En plan, podemos mirar cosas. Míralo. Esto es lo que me enseñaron ayer. Esto está bastante guay, ¿eh? El Oxel. Oxel. O Axel. O Axel. Muy buena iniciativa esto. Mira. Purpose. O Axel is a Windows Reverse Shell Payload Generator and handler that abuse the HTTPS protocol to establish a beacon-like reverse shell based on the following concept. This is the victim, okay? Victim machine running OAuth serve payload, okay? This and command output. I think this is the both ways. HTTP GET request. Use it as a beacon, checking for issues command every X second. No llega ni a un segundo, 0,8 segundos por defecto. If the GET request beacon response body includes an issued command, it is executed and the output is sent via post request back to the attacker. Ok, te pones como un HTTPS o un HTTPS. Se podría probar esto, ¿eh? This concept, which could possibly be implemented by using protocols other than HTTP or even sockets, pre-installed access, can be used to establish systems that promote the illusion of having an actual shell. Compared to traditional reverse shell, this is a compared to a traditional reverse shell, this is kind of fake. That's why, despite the name of the tool, I like to refer to such implementation as a hoax shell. A bit unconventional as it is, hoax shell did well against AV solutions. Check AV bypass POC tables for more info. Although it is now the oh my fucking god, que me da un paro cardíaco. Vale, susto tú. Vale, pues me voy a callar 2 meses Vamos a poner aquí el de estudio, ¿vale? Vamos a darle iniciar una horita. Vamos a subir el volumen un poquito de esto, ¿vale? Voy a dejarlo así, porque de momento no tengo otra escena. Así que me callo. Buah. Qué liada, tío. No he podido avanzar una mierda, loco. Me he quedado atascado porque el sistema... Es que soy gilipollas, tío. Ahora me he dado cuenta que la ISO que me he bajado para hacer las pruebas era la más... Una de las más recientes de versiones de Windows. Y me estaba dando problemas por todos los lados. Mira. 22H2. A ver si encuentro ahora lo que busco, porque macho... Tengo tantas cosas por aquí que ya no sé ni dónde está. Esto lo voy a quitar todo. Está aquí. Bueno. Man, still bypassing WAC. Yes. I'm gonna open the light, I think. Oh my fucking god, dude. I'm so fucking stupid. I'm so stupid, dude. I was using the wrong ISO. I have the right one. This is the right one. I think I'm gonna delete this virtual machine. I think I'm gonna delete this one. Yes. Bye. Your hardware must be very strong. Well, I have this. I think I can show this. I have a Intel 9th generation. Yeah, not bad. 32 gigabytes of RAM. What I need is a graphic. I don't think I have Nvidia. I don't have this installed any of this. I don't know how can I say what type of Nvidia I have. What I think I have this one. Grafica. I have this one. Yeah, this one. But I think I have the 8 gigabytes and not the 6 gigabytes. 8 gigabytes. 8 gigabytes. Yeah. Jesus. Yeah, this is not good at all. But it worked for me because I don't play games that requires me the graphic to be powerful. What I need is the 32 gigabytes of RAM because I use the RAM to virtualize a lot. Now here I have the lab. I have a Windows server with a Active Directory, and I have my Kali Linux, which is the one that I use to impersonate a cracker or a malicious people, a hacker. Well, it's not a hacker, but. And I'm on i5 second gen laptop. I wish I could virtualize like you. I have plans to build personal AD environment. Yeah. For the next
chapters about this book. I have to need the lab, the IAD lab, because we will start doing extraction of credentials with Sam, with Mimikatz. I have a lot of things. We have impersonation, the NTLM, the version 1, NTLM version 2. We have the golden ticket, silver ticket, cracking hashes like LMN and NTN, cracking with hashcat, pass the hash with Mimikatz. We have a lot of things to do with in this book. Pass the hash with Windows Credentials Editor. Pass the hash with SecSec. This is a common one. NTLM relay within packet. Yeah. This book is amazing. I like it so much. We can get credentials with NTLM with responder. Getting the hash. Any English version of PDF? Well, I don't think. Oh well. I can search it. Right now you have me. Let me. You get me. You cut me off guard. You cut me off guard. This is. You cut me off guard. I don't know if I'm saying this right. Let me use Google Translate.
You caught me off guard.
Oh, you caught me off guard. This accent, dude. You caught me off guard. I have to search it really good. I don't think. Actually, we can search it, but let me search it. Hacking Windows English version. We can actually do something. not in English, but yes, in Spanish. Oh, you have to be log in to download this. Fuck, I don't want to log this. Okay, maybe I can help you, but it will take a little bit of time, because I'm doing it. I'm not translating all the book, but I'm taking notes here in my GitHub. This is not my